continuing with the Halloween Horror Nights lead up, I decided to buy a model, and I'm going to make that. Yes, that is just going to be this next video. It'll keep me busy and, you know, make a nice video out of it. So, without further ado, let's get right to it. Okay, so right off the bat, number one has me putting that to the side and taking this. And I have to find a couple of the pieces that match that, so I can do that. I'm also going to... I just remembered. I have to find my black paint. Because I'm going to try to paint the steering wheel black and... what else? The, just like maybe the front cabin of the vehicle. Then I got to move on to making the roof rack. So... I just remembered I also need my glue. Okay. Yes. It starts, and I wasn't prepared. Oh. Thank you to the person in Canada for sending me this decal. Very, very appreciative. They also sent me the patch that matches for their franchise. I really, really appreciate that. Well, there you have it. Steering wheel is being glued on as we film this. That is gluing. Hopefully it dries fast, because next step is to take this here and we're going to paint. We're going to paint that black. Look at that. I got my tripod out. So, I said I was painting that. Now, I stopped the video because I wanted to look for something, and I didn't find it. Well, let me be honest with you. I found it, but it wasn't the right thing. It was the right color, but it was a spray paint. So I was like, nope, already glued it on, can't do it. So I'm just gonna finish up here. I'm not used to filming like this. This is so hard to do it like this, because it's hard to judge when you're not actually looking. Yeah. So I'm just... this feels so weird doing it like this. Not actually seeing where I'm going. My brain is like, what are you doing? I'm watching... oh my gosh. Yeah. That is so weird. Alright, I just got paint on the other side of that thing. Let's see. Yep. It don't look that bad. There's some spots that I missed. I'm trying to get to, but being hard to. So, at least the steering wheel is painted. I also put the computer in. Glued that. And then there's a little control box in there. It's hard to see the textures on it, but I glued that in as well. So now I'm going to actually... ooh, no. I don't want to do that. That's not good. Left my super glue unplugged here. And that could have dried up and wouldn't have been very nice. So, I'm going to try to put this dashboard in. The hooks should go right in, but they're not. One second. Okay, so that's an odd fit, but it is in the holes. So what else actually has to go on here? Thank you. Okay. So I finished the interior. I don't know if I should paint the bottom of it. It doesn't say to paint the bottom. But I don't know. It's not going to be seen by much besides myself. I do want to fix that little problem right there in the front. I will do that right now on camera here without the what's it called? The time lapse. Let's do it right here. Yeah. Get all the spots, make sure everything looking good, and you know, because if you're gonna do something, do it right, right? But I have an idea with the windows that might not work. I'm going to try it anyway when I get to that point. In the original movie, and I believe in the second movie, I could be wrong, but I think it is in the second movie as well, the windows of the Ecto-1 were tinted. They had a little strip. It's not coming off. They had a little strip of glass where you could look in, but for the most part the windows were tinted. So I'm thinking about doing that with duct tape. Not duct tape, electrical tape. You know? Because if I want to remove that, I could just take it right off. And it would give that look of tinted glass where it should be. Okay. I'm done with the black right now. I still have to glue on a couple things and go from there. So I will be right back. Okay. I have to admit, I'm a very honest person. So today is day 2. I went ahead and painted some more of the inside. This is not complete. I will paint more of that to make it a little bit more better. Just waiting for it to dry, then we'll go from there. So right now I'm gonna wait for this to dry, this part here, because it's all glued and whatnot, so I'm not gonna need this yet. So I'll put that to the side and we're gonna move on to the roof rack. And the reason why this is the second day is because you see where it says like FDAAFNA blah blah blah. Well, those are all different paints that I need. And I swear I had them, you know, like the yellow and whatnot, because the yellow, I know I had yellow, because I did this. I painted the yellow on that and, you know, painted that blue. Painted the yellow on that as well. So I know I had yellow, I just don't know where I put it. But this was the Hot Wheels Ecto-1. And I didn't like how everything was just all plain Jane up here. So I just took some paint to it. I still have to paint that white. That little... There. That actually, in real life, is a marine... I think it's a GPS. But enough of this. Okay. So there's most of the pieces. I have to put this together right now, but before I even decide to put them together, I have to paint every single one of them. So, I'm going to stop this for a second. I'm going to paint, and then I'll show the assembly. Oh, there's a lot of painting going on, and it's looking all right. Can't really say it's not, but I'm pretty much done with the roof rack now. There is some other things I need to do, but they come on later. So right now, I'm actually going to move on from the roof rack. We're going to move this to the side here. And there is some pieces right here. These pieces all have to be painted red. So that's just like that. I'm going to paint both sides of them red, of course. And then go from there. Okay. So I just set up the tripod. This is actually day 3. I have to be transparent in my videos, so, and honest, it's just who I am. But at day three, I've just been really taking my time with painting and getting everything taken care of. It's been eventful. When you're gluing this stuff, it takes a long time to glue. So I mean, I'm just making sure everything is going well, and you know, I don't want it to look stupid. So I'm just taking my time. If something needs an extra coat, I'll do it. Like that roof rack I started yesterday. Because I said, look, I'll be right back. I'm just going to finish this in the video here. And I did. I went out there and I finished it to where it should be. And it looks good. It's not as good as I'd like it to be, but it's good. Right now, I just really want to get this... this video all out and whatnot and painted and just finish it. And then what I do with my models is I'll just finish them off camera. You know, there's no reason to. What I mean by finishing them off camera, if I see a mistake, I'll take care of it. You know, I'm not going to actually finish it off camera, but, cause I really want to show the step-by-step process that I'm doing with this and make a nice video out of it. Now, I have no other ideas for video, so this is perfect. You know, I get to show what I love doing and can be artistic and whatnot, and really enjoy it, because I mean, I like art. I've always loved creating, and the video that I make for YouTube and whatnot, you know, it enhances that, and I'm grateful to be able to do something that I love all the time. You know, I'm starting a new business with creating stuff, and I'll be selling things, and it'll help my mind. I don't like globbing it on, so I don't have to keep going back. I could just reuse what's on the item that I'm painting. See, just take that. You get that little glob there, so you can just wipe it all down the line. Now, I don't have to paint the whole thing, because that part's not going to be shown. It's going to be completely glued. Just got to make sure the fins in the back get shown, because they will be shown. Definitely will be shown. So I'll put that down. I'll have to touch it up again. No problem. Now I just gotta let these sit and dry. But yeah, I'm excited about the new business venture and whatnot. And, I can't work for people. I can't. I have to. I've done it my whole life and always been miserable and whatnot. So when I opened my old store, you know, it was good. I made my own hours. I was happy. I was struggling. It was stressful. You know, but I learned a lot. And I love the person I grew into because of it. You know. And this new store, totally different venue, avenue, or whatever you want to say. And I have a lot of high hopes for it. And I meet a lot of cool people, as I did in the other store. I'm on a quest for happiness and positivity, and also to be successful. I'm trying my hardest to be successful. And, when I don't have to worry about money anymore, that's when I'll know I'll be successful. I don't plan to get rich. I don't want to get rich. I just want to be able to say, you know what? I don't mind spending the extra dollar. You know, I don't mind supersizing my meal. I just want to be comfortable. That's all, you know. I'm planning on moving to Wilmington, North Carolina. go out there for a couple days, see how it is and whatnot. A lot on my plate for the future. I really like Testers paints. I really like those paints. They're pretty good. For the most part, I've been using this. Okay. So, I have to glue that on. I did glue the fins on. There was some paint smearing, so I'm going to paint that with white paint. Not a problem. Not worried about it. Looking really well. Got the front on. I painted the lights in the front. I added these little tiny fin lights on. The rear fins, or the rear bumper, you can see the silver, does not line up right. That is not my fault. That is factory. And that is very unfortunate that nobody has fixed this problem. Could be a bad batch of, you know, whatever, but whatever. Good old Coca-Cola. Or Sam's Cola, whatever. Same thing, right? Anywho, still got more to do. Slowly but surely, it's coming along. Put the wheels on. And I did have to drill them out. The holes out. It was just not going on. So I drilled it just a little bit bigger for the opening. And then I glued them on. They still roll perfectly. No problem. But so little by little, it's coming together. It's a really fun build. It's keeping me busy and keeping me out of trouble. So let's continue. Okay, so that is officially glued on. And I just added these two little lights to the front. Now, I just glued the signs together. There's a piece of my hair on it. Don't know how that happened. Doesn't matter. Now I have to paint those black. Then they will be glued on. So, it's taken forever. It's going to be like a 4 or 5 day thing. But it's going to probably be like a 15 minute video or not even. But it's taking shape. I'm liking it. That's all glued on, finally. Can't wait to finish this. Okay, so I put the chassis together. It's still not done yet. I just finished painting this and putting the decal on. You're going to need some warm water to remove the decals from it. So I did that. The car is about 85% done. I have to do the decals. I still have to paint these two blue. So that'll be done tonight. And then I'll do more of the decals in the upcoming day or time. Because I also have to do something tonight. But it is looking really, really good. I am very impressed with it. I do have to do some cleanup with it and everything before it's, you know, 100%. But right now, it's about 85% done. And I'm just blown away by this. Well, y'all, it is finally finished. There is some things I need to clean up. Like that. There was a red paint. So I was like, oh, I'll just paint it over with white. So then it started doing that. And I gotta fix that. But it is finished. It's finished enough that I could put it on YouTube and say, hey, it's completed. I did it, you know? So I put the decals on, phone number. The hoses are now painted blue and attached. That's all up there. Complete. Spin it around. Ecto 1A. License plate on there. Got the word back up there. I still got to finish that red paint that was smeared. You could tell I started to, and I was like, I don't want to risk it. Can't risk it for the biscuit. But the logos are on there. There was supposed to be one up here, but I just think it looks like trash if I do that, so I'm not going to do it. Even though it was on the real car, I think it looks like trash. Got the one in the back there, but it's done. That is the Ecto 1A from Ghostbusters 2. 30 years old. That movie. Yeah. I was born June 14th. This movie came out June 19th. And it's special to me for that reason. But yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching this whole model build. I'm going to take care of it. The glue has started to come down. That is not a crack. That is the glue holding the windows in. Wow. You can tell I don't do this normally. Anywho, y'all have a good day. Use the promo code GENT on Teespring if you'd like a shirt. Get 10% off. Links are in the description. Just got to tell you that. So if you want to grab yourself a t-shirt for cheaper, that's how you can do that. I'll see you guys soon. I'll try to figure out another video. Y'all have a good night.